up the world now. Burn up the bad vibes. The higher that we go, we can go higher. Light up the world now. Burn up the bad vibes. The higher that we go, we can.
Welcome back to Consumer Lab. Today we're going to talk about the nonsense. Yes, the nonsense that other YouTubers and Apple keep trying to promote. They keep trying to say, oh, the iPhone, it's got a great camera. Its quality is building up to a DSLR or mirrorless camera. This, by the way, is a Sony Alpha 7. It's a mirrorless camera. Let me tell you something. I don't care what Apple tell you. I don't care what don't YouTube channel tell you. We just want clickbaits and all that nonsense. It's never going to happen. It's not going to happen. Forget about it. Yes, just forget about it. The physics, the science says why it's not going to happen. And this is what separates Consumer Labs from a lot of these other channels and people in general, is that they want to promote things because why? They're getting the little kickbacks. I'm here to tell you that this camera on any cell phone, this one here, by the way, just happened to be the Apple, right, Pro model, but it doesn't even matter. The quality on these phones will never, ever come to the standard of these mirrorless cameras. It's just not going to happen. It's impossible based on the physics. For example, look at the sensors on this camera. These sensors, all three of these sensors are tiny, tiny sensors. The glassware is not even top quality, right? Don't let Apple tell you, oh, it's got five lens, six lens. I don't care what many lens. They got to have a 30 lens. The quality, the glassware in here is never going to be the same standard as something like this lens here. This lens here is, by the way, is a $600 lens. This is a prime lens, a 50 millimeter prime lens made by Sony, right? This lens here is of super, super quality compared to this on this phone. It's just not going to happen. Because keep in mind, one of the top features of any camera is the glassware, right? This here is very important, especially when you're doing, you know, pictures and you want really sharp quality. That's what you want. You want great glassware, right? And another thing you want is a sensor. You want a nice size sensor. These sensors in this phone are really, really small. They're tiny. I just want to give you a look at the Sony sensor inside this Alpha 7. Watch this. Watch the magic when I open up. Watch how big it is. Watch. Look at that sensor. See how huge that sensor is? That sensor is bigger than every sensor on this phone. Every single sensor. There's three lenses here. It's bigger, probably bigger than half the whole daggone phone. So don't let anybody tell you that, oh yeah, well, you know, Apple quality, the pictures are getting to the standard, you know, getting to, I should say, the quality of a DSLR. It's just a lie. And I wish these YouTubers stopped telling this lie and giving these fib stories. It's just not going to happen. Now, one more thing I want to say is that keep in mind that, yes, you can add accessories to the cellular phone. This is true. But I'm going to tell you now, I don't care what accessory you add to this phone, it will never still build up to the quality of a lens like this. Because keep in mind, the accessories that you add to the phone is to mimic a real camera with a real lens. That's the whole, think about it, that's the whole point of it all, is to try to give you optimal, the best quality picture as possible. But the problem is, still will always be, the quality of the lens, the quality of the sensor, and of course, the fact that the processing as well. Keep in mind, once again, this is a cell phone. That's what it is. If you want to take B-rolls with it, fine. If you want to take out your phone and take some kid pictures and, you know, do some family portraits and stuff like that, that's fine. But if you're looking for quality, professionalism, the cellular phone is just not going to cut it. Now, I know what you're going to tell me. Oh, well, my friend did this. Because guess what? You have to have an eye for quality. If you don't have an eye for quality, then of course you're going to think the cellular phone pictures are great. But if you took that cellular phone picture and put it in right next to a photo made by Alpha 7 or Alpha 1 or any other quality, or Nikon, Canon, any one of those real cameras, you're going to say, wow, oh, I understand. Yeah, you're right. Because there are situations with the camera, with a real camera, that just a cell phone can't do. It just can't do. Especially when it comes to low lighting, when it comes to dealing with different types of colors, you know, the color science that's involved. I mean, there is just so many levels here that a cell phone just can't do. But for your average day, you know, picture that you want, yeah, sure, it'll do it. It'll do it, no problem. If you want a B-roll, fine. It'll do that too. But if you're trying to really get into quality and professionalism and something that's really going to stand out, and listen, let's take 1 minute here for a second. Let's take a minute. Think about it. If you start in a business or you try to make that money, you got to get that check up. Are you going to take pictures with a, you know, sell it, take pictures with a cell phone and sell them as professional pictures? If the person don't have an eye, they might be okay with it. But if you got an eye for quality and you know the details of your picture, then you're going to want something like this. You're going to want a real camera or a video camera for that matter. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to want a cellular phone. I mean, it's great, you know, for what it does. But when it comes to really, you know, having things pop and all that, you want the right tool for the right job. Now, I know you're going to say, well, what about the software? Software could do a lot of corrections. But let me tell you something. A software can do some corrections, but let me tell you, it's like a hammer and a nail, or using a screwdriver to put a nail in, right? Think about it. I can have a hammer and I'll knock that nail in 1, 2, 3, or I can get a back of a hard edge screwdriver and I can take days and days to get that same nail in the wood. Do you get my point? You use the right tool for the right job. And please, all you YouTubers out there, all, you know, the Apple and all these Tim Cooks and all these clowns, stop with the, oh yeah, the phone. It's not. Don't even try to put it on the same level as a real camera. Just don't do it. This is Consumer Labs. We just want you to see, you know, get the real taste of a real camera from a real lens. You know, just let you know what's going on, what's going down. Until next time. You know what? We'll talk.